this is the story that has me fired up tonight. Once again, conservative radio has reared its ugly racist head. Right-wing relationship expert Dr. Laura Schlessinger repeated the N-word while she was talking to an African-American caller on her nationally syndicated radio talk show. Take a listen.
How about the N-word? So the N-word's been thrown around.
Black guys use it all the time. Turn on HBO, listen to a black comic, and all you hear is... I don't get it. If anybody without enough melanin says it, it's a horrible thing. But when black people say it, it's affectionate.
Dr. Laura doesn't get it, and she didn't stop there. The caller named Jade was trying to ask for advice about dealing with a neighbor who used racist terms in her home. Jade took offense to Dr. Laura using the N-word.
I can't believe someone like you is on the radio spewing out the N-word, and I hope everybody
I didn't
heard it.
Spew out the Right. I said, that's what you hear.
Heard it.
Yes, they did.
I hope everybody heard it. So what
they did, and I'll say it again. Is what you hear on HBO. Why don't you let me finish a sentence?
At this point, Dr. Laura turned on Jade, claiming she took her ugly remarks out of context. That, of course, is what they always say. Then, in a classic conservative talk fashion, the doctor of hate cut Jade off and took another shot at her.
Don't take things out of context. Don't double NAACP me. Leave them in context. What I just heard from Jade is a lot of what I hear from Black Think. And it's really distressing and disturbing. And to put it in its context, she said the N-word, and I said on HBO, listening to Black Comics, you hear I didn't call anybody a Nice try, Jade. Actually, sucky try.
Dr. Laura went totally off the rails when her caller was just asking for advice. After saying the N-word 11 times and verbally assaulting the caller, Dr. Laura really showed how racist she is when she said this.
If you're that hypersensitive about color and don't have a sense of humor, don't marry out of your race.
Don't marry out of your race. Dr. Laura ran right over an African-American caller, used the N-word 11 times, then called Jade hypersensitive and expects her to have a sense of humor about the whole thing. Dr. Laura offered a lame apology on her website and is doing her best to make this thing go away. She has nothing to worry about. It seems to me that the conservative media can really say and do whatever they want, and they're going to get away with it, and they're never going to have to pay a price. Back in 2005, a former education secretary Bill Bennett said this on his radio show, quote, "You could abort every black baby in this country, and your crime rate would go down." Bennett did a masterful job of wordsmithing his way out of that situation. His show is still on the air today. Rush Limbaugh made a career of racially charged remarks, including this one.
This president, I think, has exposed himself as a guy over and over and over again who has a deep-seated hatred for white people or the white culture. I don't know what it is.
Radio programmers must think that kind of hate is entertaining. They forced the Drugster Show on 600 radio stations across the country. Glenn Beck, the rising star of the right-wing network across the street, has never had to apologize for some of the things that he's been saying. Here's some more.
If Obama weren't black, he'd be a tour guide in Honolulu. Or he'd be teaching Saul Alinsky constitutional law or lecturing on it in Chicago.
Pretty clear, isn't it? Being a conservative talker means that, hey, you're in safe haven. You can say whatever you want. You got Rupert Murdoch behind you. You got conservative radio owners behind you. They circle the wagons. They protect the talent. These guys really never have to answer for any racist or ugly remarks that they ever make outside the mainstream media. Thankfully, the mainstream media has to play by a different set of rules. When the Drugster was on ESPN, he got fired for saying racist things about quarterback Donovan McNabb. Don Imus was dropped by CBS Radio for some of the racist things he said about the Rutgers women's basketball team. Jimmy the Greek paid the price for his racism back in the 80s. It's Mel Gibson. It's Michael Richards. The list goes on and on. There is accountability in the mainstream media, but all those people deserve to get fired, and it's time for the conservative media themselves the question, where do they want to go? They don't want to go anywhere. They love where they are right now. They love being offensive. They call it entertainment. And there'll be more that are going to be throwing the N-word out there until somebody puts their foot down. There are seven words that we can't say in broadcast. Should we put the N-word and make it eight words?